On a normal keyboard, there are many keys that we use a lot, but are quite far away. Think, for example, about the at, the dollar symbol, or the parentheses. They are all in the number row. And even worse, what about the arrow keys or the number pad? You have to move your whole hand to reach those. But what if I told you that you could fix that and create a keyboard tailored to your specific needs? Let's find out how. You see, normal keyboards have everything predetermined. Even when there is an additional function key, like on your laptop or on Apple keyboards, you cannot change what that key does. Everything is fixed. A programmable keyboard, on the other hand, lets you customize everything. You can change the default layout, that is the disposition of the keys, and also create multiple layers. Think about these layers like that function key, but you can customize what it does, and you can have multiple function keys and put them wherever you want on the keyboard. Wanna know how to do it? Let's get into it. Let's start with the default layers that come pre-configured with the Digma keyboard. I'm going to use the Digma Race 2 as an example, but the layers on the Digma Defy are very similar. The Digma keyboards come pre-configured with three layers, the default layer and two more layers. The base layer looks like a normal keyboard. You have your numbers, your backspace, your enter, your spacebar, your modifiers, everything is where you would expect it to be. However, the Digma Race 2 is a 60% keyboard, which means that it doesn't have a function row and it doesn't have arrow keys. Where are those? Well, they are on different layers. For example, on layer 2, you have the arrows and the number pad. If I press this key, you can see that here I have the arrows and here I have the number pad. I can also access that layer with the same key on the other hand. That way, if I need to use the number pad with my right hand, I can press the key with my left thumb and use the number pad with my right thumb. And if I want to use the arrows, I can press the layer shift with my right hand and use the arrows with my left hand. Some people also press the layer key with the same hand that they're gonna use the arrows, and that's totally fine too. In this layer, you'll also find some convenient keys like page up and page down, home, end, or print screen. Now let's see where the F keys are. Those are located in layer 3. If you press this key or that key, you will access layer 3. The F keys are on the number row. We also have media keys, the Bluetooth pairing button, the battery level, you have volume up, volume down, mute, display brightness up, display brightness down, sleep, turn off, LED off and on, and LED effect next, and previous. So, as you can see, the default layers of the Digma Race 2 let you access the basic functionality of a keyboard much more comfortably. The F keys are closer, the arrows are closer, the number pad is closer, and other functions that you might need to reach to a media key row are also closer to your fingers. However, sometimes you don't want to be holding this thumb key all the time while you enter numbers on an Excel sheet, for example. Fortunately, there are different ways to access layers that prevent that. For example, this key here works in three different ways. If I hold it, I can use the arrows or the number pad while I hold the key. If I tap it, I can press one of the numbers and then immediately it will go back to the first layer. And the most important and most interesting one, if I double tap it, it will lock to that second layer. And now I can press all the numbers and they will be inputted in the screen without going back to the previous layer. And once I tap the same key again, it will go back to my main layer. This is really comfortable if you need to use a layer for a long time. Like for example, like we mentioned, you wanna input some numbers on a spreadsheet, then you double tap, you put the numbers, and then you tap again and you go back to your main layer. That is called a one-shot key. Now that you know the default layers and your way around them, it's time to start customizing them a little bit. That is really easy to do. You just open BaseCore, our configurator software, press configure on your keyboard, go to the layout editor, select the layer that you want, let's say navigation layer, and then select the key that you want to edit. For example, I use the at a lot and it's normally on the number 2 and that is far away, difficult to reach. So I want to have the at under the letter A, which is here on the pink. So I just go to Basecore, I will select the key, I will select the number 2, and in case of Spanish, I need to add the modifier here, which is right alt. In English, it will be shift 2. So you just select the key and the modifier, you create the key that you want. Maybe you want to assign it a nice color, so it pops up, and you save the changes. And now, if you press that key, you will see that now it's red, and if I press it, it's the at. As you can see, there's some real estate in these layers to add some custom keys. We recommend creating purpose-specific layers. For example, a layer focused just on symbols, or on navigation, or for number pad, or for example, even for a mouse layer, or for shortcuts. Let me grab my Demodify, where I have all my customized layers, and show them to you. Okay, let me show you some of my purpose-specific layers. Let's start with an easy one, my navigation layer, which is very similar to the navigation layer that I showed you before, but instead of having arrows in one side and the number pad on the other side, it has arrows in both sides, but with a twist. If I hold this thumb key, these are my arrows, and on the other hand, I have home, I have end, here I have zoom in and zoom out, I have page up and page down. These arrow keys have alt added, which in Mac lets you move one word left and one word right, and to the beginning or the end of the paragraph. Another useful layer is a layer focused only on the number pad. For example, on my layer 3, I have a number pad layer. But instead of having arrows on one side and numbers on the other, I have numbers on both sides. That way, I can write numbers with my right hand and with my left hand, because sometimes I'm with my mouse on the right hand and I want to write numbers with my left hand. And I access that layer with this key here, which is a one-shot layer. Like I showed you before, if I hold it, I'm on that layer while I hold it. If I tap it once, it will be on that layer until I tap any key. And if I double tap it, I will stay on that layer as long as I don't tap that key again to go back. Now I want to show you one of the most useful layers that I have, and that is my symbols layer. If I hold this key, I can access all my symbols. I have my brackets, my other kind of brackets, the parentheses, the greater than and smaller than, euro symbol, dollar, all the symbols that are usually far on the right of the keyboard, or maybe in the number row, or maybe you even need to do Control Alt to reach them. They're all in one layer. I like to think about this layer kind of like an alternative shift, and that helps my brain a little bit, because instead of having shift on my pinky, I have shift here on my left thumb, and on the opposite thumb I have this second shift, which is my symbols layer. Another purpose-specific layer that is really useful is a shortcuts layer. Personally, I don't have one. I kind of mix the navigation layer and the shortcuts layer. Let me show you. As you can see here, I have some shortcuts down here and another shortcuts here, like the print screen or close window or close up. And then I have Command-Z, Command-X, Command-C, Command-V, and Shift-Command-C, which triggers my keyboard. But ideally, if you're gonna have a lot of shortcuts, you should have a layer specifically for shortcuts. Finally, I want to talk about a purpose-specific layer that is a bit advanced, which is the mouse layer. If I hold this key, you can see that I have mouse up, mouse left, mouse wheel up, mouse wheel down, mouse wheel right, mouse wheel left. I also have here click left, click middle, and click right. So if you master this layer, you can move around your desktop without having to use your mouse. This mouse key layer is a bit difficult to master, but it can be useful in some scenarios where you don't want to use the mouse. One problem that you will encounter once you start creating many layers is that you run out of thumb keys to put them on. Fortunately, our keyboards have a lot of very comfortable thumb keys, but not all of them are as easy to reach. So you want to make the most out of them. The best way to maximize the real estate of the thumb keys is to use what we call Add Key on Tap. Add Key on Tap lets you have something on tap, like for example space, enter, or backspace, and something on hold, like a modifier, but also a layer shift. Let me show you my thumb cluster and you get the idea how I make the most out of it. For example, on this thumb key, I have backspace and shift. But on the other thumb key, I have space and my symbols layer. On this key here, I have Enter, but also Shift to my navigation layer. In this one here, I also have Enter and my mouse key. This one here is the one-shot layer that takes me to my number layer. And I also have other tricks to access program-specific layers, like for example, the layer that I have for ClickUp, which is a software that we use similar to Notion for organizing our workload. If I hold this key, I will access macros that let me customize the format of the text on that software. For example, if I click here, this will become blue, red, yellow, or green. And if I press here, this will be H1, heading 1, heading 2, heading 3, or heading 4. And now that I've talked about program-specific layers, let me give you some ideas that can help you make the most of layers and a programmable keyboard. For example, like I just said, you can create a layer specific for Notion or ClickUp or Word, so you can edit text easily with shortcuts and commands. Like for example, on ClickUp, you need to type slash checklist to create a checklist, but you can create a macro that does that and then just press the key and you have the checklist. The same thing for Notion and also for Word. If you are a video editor, you can have a layer specific for video editing. That way, you can move everything to your left hand, move the right hand away, and have more space for your mouse. We've made videos about those three things: Notion, video editing, and photo editing, and you'll find the links in the description below. And also, our community has shared great layers over the years. I'm gonna show you some of them so you can get some inspiration. And we'll also put a link in the description below to download it. For example, we have this Excel layer from Cole, which has the number pad, all the symbols that you need to operate, and also a lot of shortcuts specific for Excel. Here is also a Visual Studio Code from Snips, how do you say that? That lets him streamline his workflow on Visual Studio Code. Here is also a gaming-specific layer for the DeFi from Gerrit, which moves WASD from this position, which is not as comfortable, to this position, which is much more comfortable. And also in this layer, the modifiers are moved one column, so they're easier to reach too. There is also an AutoCAD layer with a lot of macros and even a single-handed layer by Nick A, which is actually a combination of two layers where all the keys are in that pair of layers and he can type with just one hand. Normally, when you have an app-specific layer, it's best to have a lock layer that will take you to that layer. That's very easy to set up. You just select the key, go to Layers, select the layer, and then select Turn into Layer Lock. It is very important that you also set a layer lock to the original layer on the destination layer, because if not, you will be trapped in that dimension or in that layer. We are here! Hello! Picasso here! And that's it! If you want to see more layers from the community, head over to digma.com/discord. There is a channel specifically dedicated to sharing layers. And if you want us to do a video about layers for a specific app, please let us know in the comments below. And if you don't want to miss that video, make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you get notified when we publish it. And now I'm going to shift to the layer where I have the off button, and you won't see me anymore. Bye!